Hello, you guys! I'm so excited. I'm going to be going over my study notes with you all today from reading the book of Philippians. It was a short book, only 4 chapters, but so impactful, and I cannot wait to share it with you. So come along with me and let's dive in deep.
Philippians 2:13 really hit me because I've been told a lot in my life. Like, girl, you got a lot of energy. Slightly embarrassing, but also like a good thing. It has helped me with certain pieces of my career, you know. Philippians 2:13 says, be energetic in your life of salvation, reverent and sensitive before God. That energy that you have is God's energy, an energy deep within you. God himself willing and working at what will give him the most pleasure. If you're ever thinking like, wow, I feel like I was gifted with something, what is that? God doesn't just give you these little gifts for nothing. There's a reason you have it. And if you have, take the energy that he has instilled inside of you and use it for the pleasure of him, glorify him. And that's exciting. Use your head, test your feelings so that your love is sincere and intelligent, not sentimental gush. Okay, God, I heard you. And by correcting your life through the convictions that you feel, if it puts you in a place where you feel as though you are suffering, that's okay.
This is crazy.
Everything I thought I once had going for me is insignificant dog dung. I have dumped it in the trash so that I could embrace Christ and be embraced by him. Philippians 3:8. What? It's insignificant. If you are doing what you think you need to do, if you're struggling with something, present it to him. He will come through. I cannot even explain. A big thing that we seem to have in this life, and I'm sure y'all are all aware. Sorry if you hear the crickets. This is Florida. I'm telling y'all, my hair is getting big. Crickets in the background. This is Florida. 4:1-9 talks about anxiety seems to be a curse of the age we live in, right? Many people battle panic attacks, fear, worry, or stress. It is difficult to find our bearings during our tough days. We're dealing with financial pressures when we're experiencing relational discord, but Paul reminds us of a better way. Our faith should be a source of strength when our natural tendency is to worry. But how do we move from fear to faith? Paul starts with rejoicing, worshiping, praising him. When we choose to rejoice, we take our eyes from our problems and instead we look heavenward. It shows our dependence on the one who knows how to shoulder our problems. Next, we pray. We don't have to pretend everything is fine. We don't have to push down our worry. We can express it authentically to the one who already knows everything we're about to say. In that circle of prayer, we ask Jesus to help us manage our daily anxiety. Paul reminds us that we can ask God for help in every situation. Once we entrust our worries to him, surprising peace envelopes our hearts. That's a word. And experience the amazing grace of the Master, Jesus Christ, deep within yourself. Have a great week.